Today, economic activity threatens the environment and vice versa. We must therefore radically change our modes of consumption and production in ways that can respond to the climate challenges of the century that we are facing. Oxfam's last report has shown that between 2016 and 2021, severe hunger has increased by over 120% in the 10 countries most exposed to climate change. And the inequalities arising from this process might actually reinforce natural imbalances, and it might hamper the implementation of appropriate developmental policies in these countries. Broadly speaking, ecological transition can have two main origins. First, it may be necessitated by the degradation or complete loss of ecological systems or biodiversity, which will then require the implementation of what we call adaptation policies. This is the case, for instance, in Vietnam, which is a country facing a serious threat of sea level rise, which might actually lead to the complete disappearance of the Mekong River Delta and might actually threaten the food and economic security of the country. And second, they can also involve the implementation of voluntary policies in order to reduce the impact of our economy on nature. And this is what we call mitigation policies. A good example of this is the increased use of renewable energies, for instance. And the problems that the southern economies face are twofold in this sense. First, a group of southern economies is heavily dependent on the extraction of natural resources, both for domestic consumption and for exports. And second, most of these southern economies do not produce the goods necessary for the energy transition, and here I mean solar panels and electric cars, and therefore will face elevated import costs if they would like to transition to a low carbon economy. Ecological transitions bring about changes that should not be underestimated. They have profound effects on sectoral employment, on public finances, on financial stability, on exports and imports. And if we would like to support the transition efforts of the governments, we would need to enable the policymakers to correctly assess the impacts of climate change on their economy and to correctly evaluate the impacts of their planned policies in the future. And this is exactly what the models are used for. They enable us to quantify the impacts of climate change and to quantify the effects of adaptation policies so the public policymakers can take the right decisions. At AFD, we have developed two complementary modeling tools to assist policymakers. First, we propose the ESTEEM model, which assesses the current risks of transition for each country, by focusing on the fact that some industries will diminish while others flourish during the transition. So by using international databases on production and trade, we assess three types of risks using the ESTEEM model: fiscal, socio-economic, and external risks. And second, we have also developed the GEM model, which is a dynamic multi-sectoral macro-financial model, which we use in order to assess the long-run impacts of adaptation and mitigation policies. And I'm talking 20, 30, 50 years here. And depending on which country we are working on, we adopt the GEM model with our local partners to match the specificities of the country and to make sure that we consider appropriately the climate risks faced by that country. And then via simulations, We can analyze the long-run behavior of economic variables and their dynamics in order to assist the policymakers. For example, we have implemented the GEM model in Tunisia, where we tried to assess the impacts of loss of agricultural output due to climate change on the Tunisian economy. And by using crop production projections in a model of the Tunisian economy, we have shown that the cost of no action against climate change is very severe in Tunisia, as acknowledged by the policymakers also. And we have also shown that the planned adaptation policies, particularly on increasing water resources and making better use of water, will mitigate or even offset the negative effects if they are implemented successfully. What's important to understand here is that both of these tools, GEM and ESTEEM, have the common objective to enable countries to build strongly sustainable trajectories. And that's to say sustainable economically, socially, and ecologically.